Hello everyone and welcome back to another video. Today I'm going to go over some recent Beatles related finds that I've managed to pick up in the last couple weeks. We got a little bit of everything here. We got some books, some music, and a film. So we'll kind of go through everything that I've got here. It's not a whole lot, but we'll just check it out together here. The first thing that I got is a gift from my friend Robert P. Thank you, Robert, for sending this my way. And this is the 50th anniversary special collector's edition of the Beatles' Let It Be. And as you can see here, it's the complete stereo remaster 2020. Now, of course, this isn't technically an official release, but it's really nice to have this upgraded audio. As you can see here, we got two CDs and a DVD of the film. The first CD and part of the second one here is the complete stereo remaster of all the audio from the film itself. And then on the second part here of the second CD, it's the complete rooftop concert, which has all been remastered there, which is really cool to have. Here we'll take a look inside at the discs themselves. Here we got CD 1 and CD 2 here. And then we also have the DVD here on this cool red Apple label. So I appreciate Robert sending that my way. And I've had a chance to watch this on. It sounds really good and looks good. We'll just hopefully get a better upgraded version coming out later this year with the new Let It Be release on film. Next up, I got the next in Bruce Spicer's series of Beatles album books. This one here covers the Magical Mystery Tour and the Yellow Submarine albums. If you haven't checked out any of Bruce Spicer's books, definitely want to check those out. They're a great resource for a lot of great information that he's pulled together. And I like how the inside cover here is kind of the inside, looks like the inside of the Magical Mystery Tour album. And then the back cover inside looks like the back of the Yellow Submarine album, which is kind of neat. And I did order this through Bruce's website, so of course he signed it there for me, which is nice. It's gonna be a little tricky to show you some of this stuff, but I'll kind of flip through some of the pages here. Kind of get a glimpse of what's all included in this book. So we start out with The Beatles Magical Mystery Tour through the UK. And then we got different, here you can see the EPs for the British release. Let's get some good pictures here. Lots of great information in here about everything. Let's see here. Nice poster. He's got advertisements, which are always fun to see. Let's see what else we got in here. There's been a lot of stuff released for Yellow Submarine over the years. I know it's especially in recent years, it's definitely been getting kind of overdone, in my opinion, but it's still fun to look back and see all the items that were released in the 60s, even with Yellow Submarine. It's really cool. You can see here we got some of the merchandise here that's been released. Yeah, just a couple more pages here and we'll move on to the next thing. And here we got different recollections from other people about the albums themselves, which is kind of interesting to read other people's takes on that. And then he kind of goes over each track in the back here, talking about each track for the album. So yeah, definitely want to check this out if you haven't picked this up or didn't know it was available. Just be sure to go to Bruce Spider's website, or I believe it's also available on Amazon, so you can check that out for yourself. Next up, over the past few years, the website Super Deluxe Edition has been putting out some interesting booklets for Paul McCartney. In 2017, they released this book here about the producers of Flowers in the Dirt. This was kind of meant to be a companion piece to the Flowers in the Dirt archive set. And it's really nice. It just slips right in the deluxe case, like it's a part of the set itself. And then last year in 2020, they also released this special edition of 10 years of the archive releases. They go over each individual archive release, when it was released, kind of just some information about each set and things like that, and give their own opinion on each one. And then just this year, they announced the release of this one here. This is for the Paul McCartney's Press to Play album. 32 pages of content. This is the unofficial collector's guide. There was 1,000 of these that were printed, and it was supposedly the first 500 were going to be signed by producer Hugh Padgham. So as you can see, I got one of the first 500, and it's signed by him here. And author from Super Deluxe Edition, Paul Sinclair, has also signed it here. And as I say, there was 1,000 of these printed, and my number here is number 133, so I got a pretty low number there. Now, it was described that the first 500 that were ordered were going to be signed by Hugh, but I've seen at least one other person that's had a number over 500 that was signed by him too, so I'm not sure if he ended up signing all of them or how that worked out, but... Now, Press to Play is not an album that I'm overly familiar with. I maybe only listened to it once or twice over the years, but I'm definitely going to have to read through this, and maybe it'll give me a better appreciation for the album. As you can see, the first few pages here are an interview with Hugh, and then they go over track by track here, each song from the album, other songs that weren't included on the album but were recorded around the same time, like the frog song, We All Stand Together. And let's see what else we got. And we got things like Spies Like Us they talk about in there as well. And they kind of, Super Deluxe gives it their own ranking for each track too, how many stars out of 5 that they rank each song. And then here we got Remixing McCartney. And then we got some different reviews from other critics about the album. So I'm not sure if there's still any of these available on their website, but you can go to superdeluxeedition.com and see if they have any of these left for you to purchase yourself. And I don't know if they have some inside information on whether Press to Play is going to be the next archive release, but if they do, this is going to be a nice companion to that set as well. Next up, we got a couple music-related items here. And first off, I picked up the new Ringo Starr EP, Change the World. And you can see the hype sticker there. And of course, this is just 4 songs. His last EP, Zoom In, was 5 songs. And I've listened to this a few times, and I actually enjoy this EP. As you know, there's not a lot of music on there, but the songs that are on there are pretty decent. I think my favorite track on the EP is the song Coming Undone. It's kind of got a kind of a country feel to it. And if I remember right, the song Just That Way has almost got kind of a reggae flavor to it. And then it also does a cover of Rock Around the Clock as well, which is pretty good. And I also picked up the cassette version. And this is a red cassette that was released for this one. And the inside of this is pretty much the same. It's just got all the lyrics printed inside here, just in a smaller format, of course. One thing I like about these Ringo cassettes that I've been getting is they're actually in the plastic cases. I've gotten a couple of Paul McCartney cassettes, and they just have like a cardboard slip case that slides over it, which I don't really care for. These are a lot better in my opinion. And while I was at the record store, I picked up that Ringo Starr EP. I was kind of going through some other stuff that they had there, looking at the different, solo Beatles sections, and I found that they had the Double Fantasy stripped down version. And when I picked up the John Lennon Signature Box in 2010, this album was not included in there. They just had the regular Double Fantasy album included. And I never made it, managed to pick up the stripped down version. So it was kind of nice to add this to the collection, brand new. It was still sealed and everything. So they have one CD is the original album. And then disc one here you can see is the stripped down version. Kind of gets rid of a lot of the different production on there and kind of has a kind of a bare bones kind of recording. But you do also get the original as well, so that's nice. And then in the side here he's got a little booklet as well. Kind of talks about all the different stuff from the album. A few nice pictures in there. And then we got the lyrics as well. So yeah, that was really nice to add to the collection finally. And then lastly for the video, I got one more book. As you can see back here, I have the original Paul McCartney's Hey Grandude book that he released. Was that a year or maybe 2 years ago? Well, just last week he came out with this, the second in the series. This is Paul McCartney's Grandude's Green Submarine. Another nice children's book that he's written here. You kind of go on your adventures with Grandude and his grandchildren. He takes out his magic compass and they are whisked away in a green submarine, and they travel all over through land and sea, and they meet their friend Ravi. Can only imagine who that's modeled after. And then he starts thinking about Granddude starts thinking about his Nandude, his wife, and by the end of the book they do end up finding Nandude. And they kind of leave a little cliffhanger, maybe that they'll go on some adventures themselves in the next book. If there's going to be another book, it might be an adventure with her. So be sure and pick this up if you're interested in that. I read this to my kids and they really seem to enjoy it. And it is also available as an audiobook, which is read by Paul McCartney. And I did place an order for that. I think it's only from the UK that they had those, so it's being imported in from overseas. So I'm still waiting for that to arrive, but when it gets here, I'll definitely show it to you. I did get the audiobook for the first book as well, which is really interesting to hear Paul reading the story to you. So there we have it, everybody. That's everything I got for this video. I thank you for watching, and stay tuned because coming up next week is the official release of the Let It Be audio box set, so I'll be sure and make a video on that for you too. Take care, everybody.